morning, about 6:30 today. Down 210, brought some fuel down and ready to start the day. Bloody dark here. But yes, this is piled here, I'll throw it up for Mitch a bit. Stack it up a bit so we can stack more on there and then strip the rest of this. And then, yeah, once we run out of room, we'll start stacking down on the bottom. That bottom bun that I put in. Yeah, a bit cooler this morning, but figure out. Now Mitch turned up here 10 minutes ago. Track was all warmed up, so he's ready to go. I just pulled the ramp up a little bit for him, just so we can stack some more loads up. And then once he's, yeah, like I was saying earlier, once he's got that ramp full, that'll probably be all that we put on that pile, and then we'll put the rest of it down on that bun that I did down the bottom. We have to lose it down there. Not lose it, but we'll stack it up. Down a bit, fog's already gone, which is awesome, and now the red sky. Yeah, so there is a bit of rain coming tomorrow, well actually tonight, so guessing it was a red sky in the morning, shepherd's warning. Loading him onto on the side that I've already cut, so if he's on the grass I can be a little bit messy with it. It doesn't really matter because I'm going to pick it up anyway. This side I'm trying not to spill any of the topsoil into the stuff I've already cut. Tractor here because it gives me another reason to make it a bit smoother with my digging, and he's driving over it, so the smoother I make it for him, the nicer it is. So I had a bit of an earlier start today than I usually do, just because I wanted to get the fuel trailer in and that pile pulled up for Mitch. Coming out of early, a bit early, get the lights on. Right, so I got the whole house site dug out. Haven't done this driveway because I'm a little bit hesitant because the rain is coming tomorrow, but, or and tonight. So
So I'm trying not to open too much stuff up. Yeah, I don't need to right now. Mark's going to come down and we're going to figure some shit out for the driveway. Some lights and whatnot. In the meantime, I'm going to load this branches and trees onto Mitch. He's going to take them away and dump them off. Shit's a bit bloody long. I'll try and snap it up a bit. Receiver at the bottom of the bucket, on the top of the bucket. Got a cable there which I'm trying not to. Trying not to get any branches touch that, because that'll snap that pretty easily. Well, so it's about 12 o'clock now, or 11:54. Stripping this driveway down the hill. Just loaded out for the stumps and the brush and stuff that I had around. That might do it for now, actually. This section anyway. Yeah, so we've got the driveway coming down the hill. God. this section down here to get this driveway. I'm going to lower this driveway right down. So I'll start stripping the topsoil around here. A few sticks and whatnot in here, but I'll just put this pile to the side and it'll blend in. I'll separate the sticks and might even do one more load of sticks and stumps and whatnot. Just back down, am I right, Mitch? So I'll strip the topsoil and then I'll link up where the driveway's going, and then I'll start stripping the metal off. And then I'll cut the fill out of here, and this will go the bottom layer. And then once I start cutting the fill behind the house, I'll use that to cap it off, because that stuff looks a little bit cleaner, a little bit nicer. So I'll go down to about here, just above the stump, and I reckon that'll be a good height. Well, that's what it is, I can hear a rattle. I'm trying to figure out what it is today, but it's the aerial. CV aerial, it's upside down. Another magnet stuck underneath the rollover protection. The rocks. Oh, stump there, I forgot to grab. Oh, yeah. Topsoil, but it's just got the old bloody root in it, so should be right. So up top section now, cutting out this fill. There's a design up here for what I'm doing. It's just sort of this area where I'm on now. I don't even know what you call it, but bit of a weird little design. GPS keeps buggering out of me like it's about to do again. But that's pretty good material up here, which is good. Just trying to figure out exactly what I'm doing, but yeah. I've left a bit in front of me, left a bit of excess there, because it's a little bit low, so I'm going to throw that around and track it in. Thank you. right, just going to design and then see what it sort of looks like at the end of the day. I don't know if they want to put a retaining wall up behind this or what the story is. Hoping to sort of start here for the rest of the day, but not actually that much to take out. Drops off to my right on the design a bit, so yeah, a bit strange. Then that sort of means that it'll drop down quite a bit to the house, which isn't really the best way for water to go. That little, I don't even know, weird little corner terracey bloody thing. This is all that got loaded out of there, so I'm just sort of trying to shape it up into a bit of a, I guess, ramp. And then I'll get Mitch to roll it in with the tractor. And then I'll get another pile ready for him to roll in. Seal everything up and I'll just keep ahead of him, and then I got one more load of stumps to put on him, and that's a bit of a round trip, 40 minutes or so. So I'll give that to him about quarter past four or something, and then that'll see him through. While he's gone, I can seal up the other piles that he won't be able to roll with the tractor. So yeah, I got the tractor here, he's been sitting a little bit, or not bloody, not heaps, but just a couple little times he's been sitting today, so always trying to keep him busy and being productive. Because like with having the machines here and just having one sit. So yeah, making the most of this weather window that we have. So getting ready for the rain that's supposed to come tonight, so a little bit of mucking around. Ready for you to maybe get the tractor on, we'll see.
Roger.
sort of tidying up, sealing up this pile, this topsoil pile. Jump off now. Down, the easier it'll be. Doesn't be too pretty because it's just the topsoil pile, but I'm trying to shape it up, seal it up so that it be able to sit there for as long as we need it to, and it'll still be nice and dry on the inside. So let's try and climb back up about 3/4 of the way up. Should be able to trim off a nice little bit. It's pretty firm on the top anyway. That's where I've been tracking around, so let's pull it off. So I got Mitch to, he's away now, taking the stumps away. And then when he gets back, it's about 4:30, 4:40 sort of now. So when he gets back, it'll pretty much be park up time, 5 o'clock. And I'll just carry on getting this pile sealed up. So he's wheel rolled. Other one that I just showed you before, that the fill pile as well. So I'll just go there, touch up a couple little bits that the tractor couldn't quite get to. And then yeah, I'll fuel up. Still got a fuel to fill up this morning with the trailer, but I'll just top up again at the end of the day. I can take that back as well.
It's all done for the day. Got the corner all cut out. That's all to the design, so just done to the design, and then if they want to change it, they can change it. But that pole sealed up. That long that bun down there is all sealed up. So the whole site's cut out now. A little bit messy because we drove over some of the bloody sticks and shit. Driveway's all cut in around the corner. and down the hill, Stumps all taken out. But yeah, it's pretty nice material up here, really good. Should make a pretty nice pad once we get to it. But yeah, I've made that corner a little bit wider on the inside because it's a little bit too tight, but probably still needs a little bit more, but should be right. It's definitely storm coming. It's getting a bit windy, a bit cooler. But yeah, we'll see what happens for tomorrow, because if it's raining, we won't be able to get in here because it's a bit of a steep hill to get up. And also that's all the work that we're going to be doing is on that hill. So yeah, see what happens.